Read it again and then again. Once again, tell me that there is nothing bad about it. Is this language acceptable?
This language is not acceptable.
Okay, what Abu Bakr is saying is not acceptable. This Quran, it was only for 7th century.
No, it was not only for 7th century. There are teachings.
So should I get rid of? Should I get rid of this? This verse for you.
You don't need to get rid of it.
Let's get rid of this. Tell me why you are Muslim. Tell me why you are Muslim.
Muhammad says, Muhammad says,
Islam, when you go to
Muhammad says, black are the fuel of hellfire. It's not me saying. It is Muhammad saying. It is Muhammad saying. It is Muhammad saying.
Minister of Health in this country. Abstex is in all office.
He's going to get a heart attack and call.
He's
going to get a heart attack.
Yes. He is going to get a heart attack.
Your mind is become junk. The Bible is full of pornography.
Sorry.
I can't do it.
You said you are English speaker. Read it slower and clear.
I'm not an English speaker. I just came right now. I came from Austria. This is my first day that I'm in here.
Okay. I want you to read it to me. Do it slowly.
Orwell went to the prophet and began speaking to him. The prophet spoke as he had spoken to Ubaid. Then Orwell said, Muhammad told you, stay quiet. Exterminate your tribesmen, have you ever heard of the army of the Arabs who destroyed his own race before you? And if the control comes to pass, by God, I see God prominent people and whoever you are right to be, and if you are like a saint, you will go shut that control is of Allah.
There is nothing bad about it. Can you read this part again for me and then tell me there is nothing bad about it? Read it again and then again, once again tell me that there is nothing bad about it.
Where is the evidence of this?
No, I'm not right now. That's not what I am focusing. You said there is nothing bad about it, so can you read it?
Where is the evidence of this sentence that which you have written?
Okay, it's from the Tabari. Are you Sunni Muslim? Are you Sunni Muslim?
Yes, I am.
So, if you are Sunni Muslim, I am sure you know someone called Tabari. Tabari, Volume 8, page 76. I want you to read this and then tell me once again that there is no problem with it.
Sorry?
I want you to read this part again.
I know.
So do you still believe that there is no problem with this? Is this language acceptable?
This language is not acceptable.
What Abu Bakr is saying is not acceptable.
No, wait. This language is not acceptable. But if Abu Bakr said this, give me the evidence of where he has written this and said this sentence.
So this language is not acceptable. Abu Bakr is saying this, and Tabari, one of your Muslim scholars, okay, telling this Abu Bakr said this in volume 8 of his book, in page 76. It is written. It is written.
Do you have the book?
I have the book at home. It is written there.
I don't have the book.
Don't play. Go to open your phone. Open your phone. Go to the Google. Write Tabari, volume 8, page 76. Go suck blah blah, and then it will come. Do it.
Do it. There is a limit.
Go to internet. You've got phone. Open your phone. Write Tabari volume 8, page 76. Abu Bakr said, go suck blah blah. It will come up. Do it.
Look, I'm talking to you right now, right? I'm telling you, if you have written something like this, right?
you could have also bring an evidence, right?
This is
there
the
is no,
sir.
There is no evidence.
I this can is write, evidence.
I can write by myself.
Okay, show me. Prove me that I have written this by myself. Why are you so afraid? Why are you so afraid to go up on YouTube, go up on the Google and then search for it? Go to the Google, take your phone out.
I didn't bring this.
Take your phone out first. Take your phone out first. Take your phone out. Take your phone out. Take your phone out. Why are you so afraid? Are you afraid that you will see this?
You have to bring a book and evidence so that this sentence of this, which you have written it, which you have typed it, it's true.
Okay, so here's another line. Messenger of Allah instructed us, if you hear someone is boasting in an arrogant, that's something mainly for you right now.
Not arrogant, it's ignorant.
That's for you now. Men of his tribal lineage, tell him to bite his father's male member and do not use a metaphor. I think it is addressing you right now. So
right.
Now,
wait.
We did the wait. First part. Let me come to the second part.
From this first chapter, right? We are not finished.
I am listening. I am hoping that you are brave enough to go to the Sheikh Google and then find the reference.
Why should I go to the Google? You have to bring an evidence.
I already gave you the evidence. You are so afraid to go and check it, sir. You are so afraid. That's evidence. You are already having a problem. Even sir,
the internet gets it.
We have sex. The Minister of Health here. We have sex in the office.
Sir, there are websites simply using this story to justify jihad towards those who are insulting Islam. You can do that. So it is, I showed you, you read it. It is from now on, it's up to you to take it or throw it away. That's absolutely up to you. But denying is not going to help you. So you know deep down it is there, sir.
Okay, all right. Even if this is right? Even if this is okay.
Sorry?
What's wrong with it?
Okay, so now you think if this is correct, yeah. What is wrong with it?
There is nothing wrong.
Okay, so you don't say there is anything wrong with it. That's fine.
It depends upon the situation. Which situation a person say? If he was in anger, right? When a person is in anger, he can say everything he wants, right?
So because if the person is in anger, they can say whatever they want and that can be justified.
Yeah, because the mind doesn't work well at that time. And it's
sorry, say it again?
And it's up to the opposite person, you know, that how he talks to the opposite person. Maybe he has used something abusive, right? So that's why he has said like this.
So let me understand. If this is correct, which Abu Bakr is stating and Tabari is confirming it is correct, there is nothing wrong with it in the intention, because in Islam, you can say in anger whatever you want to say, correct?
No, there is nothing like this. You can say whatever you want to say. Whatever is good, you can say. Whatever is good, you can say.
Okay,
whatever
so
is wrong, it's not.
If sake of the argument, this is correct.
When in anger mood, when a person says something, you don't have to catch him at that time why you said like this.
Okay,
you know?
So. If Abu Bakr is stating this, and then
if situation he has said this, you have to think about
no context is already there. You already read the context. Do you think is this justifiable? Is this all right? Context is already here. So do you think context can justify it?
Context can justify it.
But that's fine. So if context justifies it, that's absolutely fine.
Wait, what I'm going to tell you, right? When Abu Bakr said like this, for example, right? So he might be in an anger mood, right? And the person, opposite person, he might have said something like this, so that Abu Bakr told him like this, that this words, right? So there is nothing, I think there is nothing wrong in it.
Okay.
The person can say
so anything. That's absolutely fine. Yeah. I am grateful that, sorry, where did you say you are from? Austria?
No.
Where are you?
I'm from Afghanistan.
Afghanistan.
Yeah.
So I am grateful that you can simply look at such a language, this one, and also finished? As soon as you finish your chit chat, I am grateful that you look like you are someone over 15 from Afghanistan, currently is in Britain, can simply say such a language is, depend on the situation, can be justified. Okay? So, do you think, is it ever justifiable? Is it ever justifiable to abuse and lie about Lord Jesus Christ?
To abuse and lie what?
Abuse and lie about Lord Jesus Christ.
No.
No. If someone abuses and lies about Lord Jesus Christ, what do you think should be done? Can I use such a language towards that person?
To the opposite person.
Yeah, if you lied about Jesus, yeah, will you be okay if I use this language towards you?
You are doing it the other way, you know? This word, this sentence might have said in anger, right?
How do you know it is in anger? In the context, it doesn't even imply that Abu Bakr is angry. He's making fun of people who are worshipping the pagans.
I'm not acknowledging this, sorry, telling you again. I'm not acknowledging this, whether it is right or wrong. But I'm telling you this, maybe this sentence, which you have written it, which you have typed it, right? He might have said in an anger mood, or there might be a conflict of battle, something like that. That's why he might have said this. What's wrong with it?
So my problem is, you live in Britain, and you are reading such an ugly language, and you are asking what is wrong with it. That is my problem, okay? That is my serious problem. It should all concern you. And again and again stating that you don't accept it is right or wrong. According to Tabari, it is there, it is right. That is what Abu Bakr said. It is all very much disturbing. But it is double concerning. Someone who is in Britain right now have zero problem with that. So, if anyone insults Jesus, should I use such a language? Does Islam give me justification to use such a language?
What is insulting for you?
Sorry, what's your question?
If someone is insulting Jesus, okay, should I use such a language Abu Bakr used?
In which case a person is abusing Jesus?
Insulting Jesus, yeah.
Yeah, in which case?
If someone says Jesus didn't die, that's an insult. If someone says Jesus is not the Son of God, that's an insult.
That's an insult, yeah?
That's not insult.
No. If Jesus died, that's not insult. That's his opinion. I have to see what's his opinion.
That's an insult. So, in here, see, now you are justifying insulting Lord Jesus Christ. I love to say this word, but I'm not going to pronounce it.
Abusing is this, when a person is insulting your family, for example, Gary. Something like this. He's talking rubbish words. Abusing is like this. If a person says
that is rubbish word. When someone says Jesus is just a prophet, it is rubbish word. When someone says, no, you are trying to justify your theology to me now. While Abu Bakr has nothing to justify, don't touch me. While Abu Bakr has nothing to justify.
It's just an opinion of a person. When a person says that Jesus is not that, it's his opinion. It's not an abusing word. I don't see anything abusing.
So, 21st century, Muslims continue to abuse Lord Jesus Christ by denying his death and his resurrection, by simply denying his identity, apparently that is justifiable, and Islam doesn't even give me right to use the vocabulary Abu Bakr used. Versus, in the context, Abu Bakr has no justification according to you what he said. That is disgraceful. If you are planning to stay in Britain, I simply encourage you to get hold some manners, and also I simply encourage you to run away from Islam. The Islam you brought from Afghanistan
is the way of dignity, of the way that a person can live under the Islam. Islam, what's Islam? Islam is from Salam. Salam means peace.
According to who?
According to who,
Islam means peace.
The word itself, Islam came from Salam.
According to who?
According to who? According to everyone.
No, that's a lie. Islam means submission. Bring your evidence that Islam means peace.
That's one event in his life. You shouldn't generalize it, you know.
Sorry?
That's one event in his life of Abu Bakr. We are all humans. Something like this can happen. We have emotional situations in which recurs. No one is perfect, you know.
Sorry, I'm just trying to understand. This is the statement Abu Bakr did once in his lifetime.
Okay,
therefore, we shall just turn blind eye and ignore. What are you going to do if the followers of Islam is using this to justify?
Believe me, they don't do it.
They do.
You have to check out the translation.
There is a huge article. Where is it? This one. Justifying people to be killed through jihad because simply it is acceptable in Islam. If you are insulting someone, that's the example Abu Bakr sets it. Okay, that's a huge article here.
You should prioritize other sources first. You know?
So that was the first Tabari. This is the second one. This is the Muhammad, Messenger of Allah, is talking. Okay, from Sunni sources. Can you read it to me?
If you hear someone
boasting in an arrogant manner of his tribal lineage, then tell him to bite.
Look, you have to always be aware that in those sources, you have to compare with other sources first before making a general statement. Muslims are very sensible with such sources, which was related by Al-Musnad, Ahmad.
So it is mentioned in Ahmad, classified as a Hassan, okay? And then Islam QA is justified using such actions, okay? So it is ugly action. It is ugly saying, if you are Muslim, you should be ashamed of it right now. Are you Muslim? Not laugh
yes,
at it. You should, gülmemelisin, gülmene hiçbir gerek yok.
Evet.
Çok çok çirkin, çirkin en çirkin bir şey.
Hani,
English.
Şöyle bir şey anlamı, you have to understand that the general message we get to know from the first primary sources, not to curse in the first place, not to, you know, you don't get this message anywhere in Islamic sources. But these
okay.
were collectors. Tabari was a historical.
Okay, so let's hold the hands. Can you hold the page? Okay. 5 seconds silent for the funeral of Abu Bakr that you are burying him right now. You throw him under the bus, he's gone. Okay, now, focus. Let's get rid of this. Tell me why you are Muslim. Why are you Muslim?
I'm not used to this kind of religion. Let me think first. Let me give it.
Continue. Think. I'll give you time to think. How old are you, sir?
23.
Have you ever seen your father is beating your mother?
Never.
No. If you see this gentleman is beating his wife, what would you do?
I would maybe advise him.
Can you look at me when you speak to me?
Yeah.
Because I can't hear well.
I would advise him to not to beat his wife.
So you would advise him to not beat his wife. What else you would do?
Maybe I would interfere.
You would step in?
Yeah.
Okay. If Allah is telling you that you have right to beat your wife, what would you do?
I would try to understand it in the context.
Okay, let's turn the context.
You know, there is a professor, I'm attending the Goethe University in Frankfurt am Main, in Germany, okay? And I'm studying Islamic studies and also English studies and...
Sir, I want you to focus.
Angelika Neuwirth, maybe you know her. Angelika Neuwirth, she's very famous in Germany.
I know
and
her.
She...
Let me focus. No. I want you to.
After I finish, you can.
What is your name?
My name is Michael.
Michael.
Yeah. After I finished, okay. Just you can talk. So she said, looking at the context, looking at the societal structure. The first was like a relief for the women in the time when she was treated as an object, okay? She was treated as... Women were treated as an object, okay? And Islam gave many more rights to women. If you transfer it to today, that would mean that many things in Islam has to be, you know, thought over again, and the principles behind it have to be understood. It's very common knowledge at university we don't discuss things like this because there is a transfer from the history, from the context, from the social context to today.
Let me respond. I am sorry to... I heard what you said.
Did you understand me?
I heard what you said.
Okay.
I am very sorry to hear at age 23,
yeah,
you are already trying to justify certain teachings. That is very much I am disturbed by. First of all, Islam doesn't give women any right which they didn't have before. Okay, that's a huge lie. And I am sorry at university you've been lied to. Okay, that's first point. Second point is, how can you justify in any form or shape that man is beating his wife and her skin is greener than her dress? How can you justify that in any form or any shape by under the... Look at me, focus on me, okay? How can you justify that under the teachings of Allah? Second point. Third point, have you heard someone called Khadija?
Yeah.
Who is Khadija?
First wife of Prophet.
How old? How much older? Just a moment. We just need to change the battery. Sorry, you said you are studying to be Islamic teacher. Okay. Can you tell me about Khadija?
Yeah, I've told you that she was the first wife of the Prophet.
Okay, so she was the first wife of Muhammad. Can you compare Khadija's time versus the wives of other Muhammad? Was Khadija covered up?
I'm not sure about that.
Answer is no.
Can you prove it?
Because covering entered the Islamic world after the death of Khadija.
You're claiming that covering
Surah 33 verse 59.
Before that there was no hijab, no covering.
Covering stepped in. Mm-hmm. You are going to be Islamic teacher. How come you don't know very basics? So Surah 33 verse 59. Covering comes so that you cover that you don't get abused.
Before that there was no covering?
No.
No at all, in the Arabic Peninsula.
The reason covering comes because Umar sees one of Muhammad's wives. She's large and big at night. She's like checking the woman. He's checking the woman's out. He goes to Muhammad and then says, "We need to cover the wives. Otherwise, I'm recognizing what your wife is doing." Suddenly, Allah steps in and then gives this verse of covering. So you cover that you don't get abused. Muslim woman needs to cover. Muslim man don't abuse them. Khadija did not cover. Her right of freedom to dress up what she wants to have is being taken away with the teachings of Muhammad. She was able to ask Muhammad to marry her. What happened? Islam stepped in and then take that right away from Muslims. Oh, like
I would like to see the sources first.
You give me the sources since you are disagreeing with me.
I haven't graduated yet. And you know, I'm focusing more on methodology and stuff. Not...
Let me ask you a very basic question.
I'm interested in it.
Who is training to be Islamic teacher, how are you handling the child wife?
a child what?
Child wife, child marriage.
Aisha, so there is...
Sorry, what is the name of the child wife?
Aisha.
Aisha. How old was Aisha when Muhammad had sex
she
with her?
She was young, she was young. I know the discussions.
How
there's
old?
There's always the same discussions.
How old was she?
I don't know. You have to look up the sources.
So you are going to be... Are you sure you are training to be
a
teacher?
I'm not going to be a professor at university. I'm going to teach in school.
So you are going to teach in school? You don't even know the basics of Islam?
Students who are Muslim. I know the basics.
What are you going to say to the Muslim man?
Yeah.
Imagine I am your student. Teacher, can my father have sex with your child?
Yes, and I will say no.
You would say no?
Yeah.
What is your justification for that?
It will be probably some 10 lessons or so, and we will take that, issue from many perspectives and come to a conclusion together with the class.
Okay.
And then I will let the students decide for what they are deciding for themselves. This is true.
Okay. So you will let students decide if it is true or not. Let's do very basic.
Okay.
Are you Prophet Muhammad?
I guess not.
You guess no. Okay. We can figure that out. Like, it's not that difficult to figure that out.
Okay.
Are you Allah? No, you've got two shins. Are you Allah?
I guess not.
You are not Allah. While the word of Allah orders you to divorce the child who you had sex with, who do you think you are? Lying to the Muslim students and telling them, oh, we can make a decision which is acceptable. Who do you think you are, overriding the word of Allah?
It's not about overriding the verse of Allah, it's just shedding new light on the verse of Allah, you know?
Okay, share the light here. 65:4. So you are going to be Islamic teacher, you don't even know the basics about Islam, but
basics.
You know how to lie and deceive Muslims.
I don't have the lights.
And it's not funny. Gülünecek bir şey yok gerçekten. So, did your prophet made a mistake when he climbed the top of a child?
See those things like a frame, okay? There's like a framing in a society,
context.
In a context. You know, there's a framing.
What is the context of this? While the word of Allah was existed from the beginning to end. What is the context of this? Explain it to me. Actually, before that, can you just explain me what the verse is saying?
Sorry, before I go into... I don't want to go into this verse right now. You can't just take one verse and make like a generalization from it. There's a context in which it was,
I am not taking one verse and making generalization of it. I am asking you, who is going to be the Islamic teacher? I am asking you to explain this to me. You are going to be teacher. I am sure you all studied this, and you are justifying. Explain it to me.
I'm not going to be a theology teacher. I'm not going to...
You are going to teach Muslims about Islam.
I think you don't want to understand me. I'm trying to say something to you.
You are going to teach this to Muslim children. So, how are you going to deal? How are you going to deal with this verse when your Muslim child, student says, I am going to use this, my father is using this verse to have sex with my neighbor's child. What are you
going to
do?
Do you really think that one student is going to tell me this? Do you really think that?
Yeah. Yeah. Imagine that happened. What are you going to say?
I can't imagine because it probably
it's not
going to
happen anyway.
Yeah.
It's only happened in your side. How many children been abused by your church every day?
Islamic grooming gangs, see? People are screaming out for Islamic grooming gangs again.
About children sex,
so how do you justify this?
Talk about your church. How many children been abusing the church every day on a daily basis in this country?
I don't want to use her methods. I don't want to use her methods. Like
sir, can,
a priest on a daily basis raping children.
Can you explain this to me?
Like,
what is your own reading of this?
I have told you, I will shed some lights on it.
Yeah.
And we will look at the hadith, look at the Prophet's life, look at the verses, and then we will come to a conclusion.
Okay,
and
so can we do that now?
I'm not ready to do that now, man.
Why?
Because I haven't prepared, because I haven't looked at the evidences,
So,
I've got
the tafsir with me. I've got the tafsir with me.
An Islamic teacher, he's not going to read the child. It's only happening here in England.
I've got the tafsir. So, tafsirs identified this as you are divorcing them while they are in young age. They are just a child who has been developing. So I guess my question still stands. If you are going to teach Muslims about Islam, and right now you are studying to be Islamic teacher, how are you going to handle this verse?
I have told you that I have.
I'm not satisfied with
it. I don't have evidence for it.
You don't need. How does it make you feel as a man?
You don't need to be satisfied with me. I'm not here to satisfy you.
Why not?
Okay.
You can't even give me very basic answer.
I'm trying to convey you a message. I have told you.
What is the message?
I have already given you the message. I have given you the message. What I'm telling you right now is, look at the principles which are, you know, conveyed by the Quran before you choose and cherry pick those verses.
So do you believe your prophet followed the Western law and then did that to Aisha?
Didn't live in postmodern
do you think era, you Allah followed the Western law and then asked Muhammad to practice all those kind of things?
So you are assuming that
I'm asking you the law of Allah
is like living in the postmodern era and you're treating him with the myth, with the teachings of the postmodern era.
So, you know, do you think the teachings of Muhammad should be in 7th century?
No, not all. The principles.
Okay, which
we
ones?
Should
so, which teachings of Muhammad should be buried in 7th century?
We should learn from his principles.
He has no principle at all.
The manifestations
so, which
of
teachings
principles?
Of Muhammad should be buried in 7th century? Which teachings of Muhammad should be buried in 7th century? Child marriage? Put that in 7th century? Yes or no?
That's a sociocultural context.
Should you leave the child marriage in 7th century? You leave it.
I don't leave it there. But that was a specific matter to that time. It was a specific matter to the time of the 20th century. But now the culture has changed.
Okay.
And it
got
can
it.
Change
yeah,
again to
got
that.
It. Got it. Okay, got it. So, do you think in that case, this Quran, it was only for 7th century.
No, it was not only for 7th century. There are teachings and
so should I get rid of this verse for you?
You don't need to get rid of it. You don't need
no,
to get rid
still
of
keep it.
It. It is
the verse which talks about divorcing
there,
a child should
messages.
Still stay in the Quran.
There are timeless messages.
You take in one case, there is hundreds of
cases.
The
verse which talking about the divorcing
maybe
a child should that stay in the Quran?
After 300 years, it will be needed again.
Okay, maybe in 300, we will need it. Therefore, we keep it in the Quran.
Why don't you go and stop that children being abused in this church anyway? I told you many times.
Why don't you go
why
and give your private part to Muhammad?
We have this issue one time with the Prophet and explain for you. Today in the 21st century, hundreds of children have been abused and raped
don't
in the church.
Don't cry, baby.
You just don't like the fact.
Don't cry, baby.
The gun is moving now.
Don't cry, baby.
It's too old, anyway.
So he's
why don't you go and
don't cry, baby.
I see now. How many children have been abused in this country?
Where is the
thousands, millions.
Over 300,000 girls are victims of grooming gangs.
Abuse and touches.
What grooming gangs? Yeah? Islamic grooming gangs. What is their reference? Surah 65, actions of Muhammad, as well as Surah 65. So, should I get rid of Surah 65, verse 4?
But Surah 65, in which century was referring to an age?
I have already responded to you.
Okay, we get rid of it. So now let's deal with the other one where you talked about the rights are given to the woman.
I leave you with her, but ask her the question. Where she go, there is about 10 or 15 children being abused.
Can
you need
read
to report
this
it to the police. And instead of helping the priest, you know?
Can you read this for me?
That's what you should do.
Sana kolay gelsin, ben gidiyorum.
Bundan niye kaçıyorsun ki?
Bilmiyorum, ben sana cevap.
Hayır, bir sürü yalan söyledin. Bir sürü yalan söyledin. Sana da şeyde okuduğun üniversitede yalan söylüyorlar. Sen de gelecek nesillere yalan söylemesini öğreniyorsun.
Ben gerçekten bazı şeyleri öğrenmek için anlamak istiyorum. Evet, Müslüman ailede doğdum. Ama üniversitede bak işte Alman profesörler varmış. O bunu söyleyen kadın da Müslüman değil. Ve bize birçok eseri önümüze koyup gösteriyorlar. Tamam bak. Böyle bakabilirsin.
Kadınlar Allah'tan iyi geliyorlarsa çok güzel.
Buradan bakabilirsin.
Kadınlar Allah'tan iyilerse çok güzel. Because Allah onu söylemiyor. Allah onu söylemiyor. Muhammed onu yapmadı. Sana yalan söylendi. Sana hala yalan söyleniyor. Ve seni they trained you to lie to the next generation. That is most dangerous thing, sir.
Anlamacı farklı filtreleri gösteriyor. Farklı filtrelerle Kur'an'ı nasıl anlayabiliriz? İslam tarihi nasıl anlayabiliriz? Fikirlerin nasıl gelişini nasıl anlayabiliriz? Ve işte içindeki hakikatin ve prensiplerin ortaya çıkması.
You know, you don't even have to pay for the university. I'll tell you how to make sense of Islam. Get rid of this book and get rid of all the teachings of Muhammad. Life will make sense and Islam, when it is not exist, it will make sense. And you don't have to pay for the university at all. That was free lesson for you. Görüşürüz. Apparently one of our brother is being removed from speaker's corner because lovely Muslims were in action. I'm just going to ask that to Mr. Policeman. I'm just going to the policeman. I'm coming back in a second.